The body of death actually is not just a metaphor. I told you, I'm reading this book about the Roman civilization. And the body of death, yes, it was used as a metaphor, but it's also a literal thing. Nung panahon po nila, meron pong execution or torture, ang tawag ay body of death. And this is what it means. Like, you're gonna be locked in a dungeon. So, hindi siya talaga prison na may mga bars, na maliit lang yung space mo. Ito, medyo malaki. Kasi dungeon. It's just that it's dark. But at least you can walk around. You can talk with your other inmates or dungeon mates, whatever you call them. Pero here's the thing. There's a literal dead body that's gonna be sued into you. Itatahi sa'yo yung corpse of a dead guy. Itatahi sa'yo mouth to mouth, face to face, eyes to eyes, hand to hand. Nakaganon. So imagine you're walking inside the dungeon and you have this body of death that's with you. And yes, you're alive. Yes, you can walk. But you are dying every single day because there's a dying, or not dying, there's a dead person. And imagine the stench. Imagine nabubulok tong taong to and nabubulok ka with him. Imagine the maggots and all of the bulate and the worms, that all the decomposing agents that making the body decompose is also going to you. And I don't know about you, it's worse than death. I'd rather be, barilin nyo na lang ako, pugutan nyo na lang ang ulo. Kasi yung buhay nga ako, pero every single day, literally namamatay ka. And maybe you're here today, listening to this sermon na saying, parang ganun po ako, Pastor. Yun yung sinasabi ni Paul. You're alive, but it seems like you're not really alive. You're not just dead. And you're dying every day. And you look around you, you look at yourself, and you're saying, why am I so different? Why are they full of life and vibrance and freedom? But pag tinitingnan ko sila, wala din naman silang pera. But ako parang lagi akong depressed. Pag nakita ko sila, wala din naman silang relationship. May sakit din naman sila. Bakit ako lagi akong talo? Lagi akong talunan? Lagi akong suicidal? Lagi akong negative? Lagi akong, why? What's wrong? Because probably you have the body of death in you and you're trying to remove it on your own. Sabi nga ni Paul, who can save me? Because I cannot save myself. If you have that problem, then good news. This preaching is for you. One of the things that I am looking forward now is our bedtime story with you. Well, and if you know me, if you know our family, we love reading books. And gusto namin na masali namin sa kanila yon. Gusto namin na ma-acquire nila yung pagkahilig sa books. And I think that will happen if we will read to them and they will see us also reading books. And dati kasi hindi pa, nung medyo bata pa si Yuel, hindi pa siya excited. Ngayon, he's looking forward to our bedtime story. So, may schedule kami. TTHSS, we read, I tell him Bible stories. Which is very easy for me because I just tell it about memory. Okay? From memory rather. Kukwento ko lang from memory. But MWF, other stories. Okay? And yun yung medyo hindi ko na maalala. Kaya we bought him books. Mamaya, I'm gonna, in my picture, pakita ko sa inyo. Ito, pakita ko na yung picture. Ayan. Yan yung picture. Our story 2 weeks ago is The Little Mermaid. May mabibili ka niyan sa Lazada. Nag-promote pa ako, no? Or sa Shopee. Mura lang yan. It's big. By the way, finifilter namin yung mga books na pinapabasa namin kay UL. And yung iba natuwa kasi yung story ko, Little Mermaid. Okay? Kasi lagi na lang illustration ko pang lalaki. Ayan, Disney Princess na po. Ayan, para sa mga babaeng nanonood. Gagawa po kami ng series para sa inyo. Okay? The Disney Princess series. Okay? And the reason why I'm telling this story is when I was studying about this preaching, I remembered Ariel. Okay, I remembered Ariel na she wanted to do a lot of things, but she can't. Okay, anong sabi niya dun sa song niya na Part of Your World? I want to walk under the sun. She cannot do that. She will die. Because her body is not meant to be in land. Okay, sabi niya nun, she wants to dance, she wants to walk, but she literally can't because she has tails and fins. Not she doesn't have fins, tails. Okay, kalahati po niya ay isda. And ito po yung example na you want to do something but you literally can't, hindi mo kayang gawin, incapable of doing. And when I was studying Romans chapter 8, naalala ko, ito yung sinasabi ni Paul. Sa chapter 7, balikan lang natin ano, sabi niya, "For I do not understand my own actions, for I do not do what I want, but I do the very thing I hate. Now if I do what I do not want, I agree with the law that it is good. So now it is no longer I who do it, but sin that dwells within me. For I know that nothing good dwells in me, that is in my flesh. For I have the desire to do what is right, but not the ability to carry it out." Ay, buti na lang di ako nag-preach last week. Because this is depressing. Okay? This is probably the most depressing chapter in the whole Bible. Look at that. I'm gonna highlight that. The last part. "For I have the desire to do what is right, but not the ability to carry it out." The aerial sickness. You want to dance, but you can't. You want to walk under the sun, but you can't. You want to marry Prince, what's his name? Or Prince Charming na lang. You want to marry this guy, but you can't. Kasi isda ka, mermaid ka, sa tao. You can't. Ganito yung picture nun. There's something in you that stops you from doing, incapable of doing that. It's depressing, di ba? Gusto ko namang gawin, pastor. Gusto ko namang magpakabait. Gusto ko namang maging generous. Gusto ko namang mag-make disciples. Gusto ko namang mag-preach ng gospel. Gusto ko namang iwan yung kasalanan yan. Pero bakit di ko magawa? You know what? I think may clue dito. And I'm gonna go ahead of myself a little bit. Binilang ko yung personal pronouns in chapter 7 and I counted 19 personal pronouns of I, me, myself, I. And it paints us a picture. What's wrong? Na baka kaya pala, baka kaya naman pala hindi mo magawa yung dapat mong gawin. Kasi ginagawa mo ng sarili mong lakas. You're doing it. I, me, myself. I'm trying to do what's right. I'm trying to obey the law. I'm trying. But I have the ability to carry it out. The chapter 7 ended with this. Again, very depressing. "Wretched man that I am. Who will deliver me from this body of death?" So depressing. Mag-end ka ba ng chapter ng ganyan? "Wretched man that I am. Sino ang magliligtas sa akin in this body of death?" The body of death actually is not just a metaphor. I told you, I'm reading this book about the Roman civilization. And the body of death, yes, it was used as a metaphor, but it's also a literal thing. Nung panahon po nila, meron pong execution or torture, ang tawag ay body of death. And this is what it means. Like, you're gonna be locked in a dungeon. So, hindi siya talaga prison na may mga bars, na maliit lang yung space mo. Ito, medyo malaki. Kasi dungeon. It's just that it's dark. But at least you can walk around. You can talk with your other inmates or dungeon mates, whatever you call them. Pero here's the thing. There's a literal dead body that's gonna be sued into you. Itatahi sa'yo yung corpse of a dead guy. Itatahi sa'yo mouth to mouth, face to face, eyes to eyes, hand to hand. Nakaganon. So imagine you're walking inside the dungeon and you have this body of death that's with you, and yes, you're alive, yes, you can walk, but you are dying every single day because there's a dying, or not dying, there's a dead person. And imagine the stench. Imagine nabubulok tong taong to and nabubulok ka with him. Imagine the maggots and all of the bulate and the worms, that all the decomposing agents that making the body decompose is also going to you. And I don't know about you, it's worse than death. I'd rather be, barilin nyo na lang ako, pugutan nyo na lang ang ulo. Kasi yung buhay nga ako, pero every single day, literally namamatay ka. And maybe you're here today, listening to this sermon, na saying, parang ganun po ako, Pastor. Yun yung sinasabi ni Paul. You're alive, but it seems like you're not really alive. You're not just dead. And you're dying every day. And you look around you, you look at yourself, and you're saying, why am I so different? Why are they full of life and vibrance and freedom? But pag tinitingnan ko sila, wala din naman silang pera. But ako parang lagi akong depressed. Pag nakita ko sila, wala din naman silang relationship. May sakit din naman sila. Bakit ako lagi akong talo? Lagi akong talunan? Lagi akong suicidal? Lagi akong negative? Lagi akong, why? What's wrong? Because probably you have the body of death in you and you're trying to remove it on your own. Sabi nga ni Paul, who can save me? Because I cannot save myself. If you have that problem, then good news. This preaching is for you. Romans chapter 8. Buti na lang, may Romans chapter 8. Ay, sobrang ganda nito. We're gonna do this ng two weeks lang, pero I wish it's more. Kasi ako nga, hindi ko siya matatapos. Okay, I'm just gonna up to chapter verse 4, then jump to verse 11. Scholars are saying that the Romans chapter 8 is the greatest chapter in the Bible. Sabi ni William Newell, sabi niya, there is scarcely a passage in the New Testament that is more delightful reading to the spiritual Christian than the 8th of Romans. Wow. Okay, kung gusto mong ma-encourage, basahin mo to, Romans chapter 8. Sabi ni Skip Heitzig, sabi niya, if the New Testament is like a ring, okay, if the New Testament is like a ring, the diamond is the book of Romans. The diamond is the book of Romans. Ulit, if the New Testament is a ring, the diamond is the book of Romans, and the sparkle of the diamond is Romans chapter 8. Na-excite na si Kuya, oh. Tingnan nyo yung book ends, no? Romans chapter 8 verse 1, it started with there's no condemnation, at matatapos yung verse ng no separation. Dito palang iiyak na ako, ready na ako umiyak ulit today. So I hope you're ready now. Alright? Again, drop everything that what you're doing. This is for you, this is for me, this is for all of us. Number one, our punishment is done. Our punishment is done. Tapos na siya. Verse 1. There is therefore now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. Scholars are saying that Romans 8 verse 1 is the most hopeful verse in the whole Bible. Okay, ang dami nung kanina pang inuulit-ulit ko, ano? 8 verse 1 is the most hopeful verse in the whole Bible. There is no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. Alam nyo kung anong pinaka-importante dyan sa verse na yan? Alam nyo yung pinaka-importante? Yung period. Yung period. Christ Jesus period. Kasi pag tinanggal mo yung period, nilagyan mo ng comma, nagdagdag ka, sobrang it will make a world of difference. Now, I'm gonna teach you something. Go ahead, tingnan nyo yung mga Bible nyo. Buksan nyo yung Bible nyo. Yung basin yun, hindi nyo pa nabubuksan buong ECQ. Pero ngayon, buksan nyo. May makikita kayo dyan, parang yan yung nilagay ko, merong footnote. A. Kasi may mga Bible na adds this phrase to verse 1. Okay, ayan, i-reveal ko na. Yung iba, pagka ang Bible nyo medyo luma, hindi naka-footnote, nakalagay siya talaga dyan. Kung I think, New King James Version yung Bible mo, nakalagay itong phrase na to. Pag clinic mo yan, or makikita mo sa baba nung page mo, makikita nyo to. Some manuscripts add, who walk not according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. Now, it's a lot, it's a big difference. Okay? There's a big difference. Tingnan nyo ha, pag i-add ko yan, ganito yung dating. Okay? There is no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus who walk not according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. Eh, di ba iba? May iba yung meaning niya. Before I go on, explain ko lang muna. Pastor, ano, bakit po ganun? Ba't po magkaiba? Bakit po may Bible na ganito? Meron pong wala. Okay, papaliwanan ko sa inyo. Okay, makinig kayo mabuti because someone might ask you the same question, alam nyo yung sasagot. This is what you call a copyist error. Copyist error. During those times, ay mano-mano po na kinukopya yung Bible. Wala pong computer na i-control C, control V. Mano-mano. So, with that being said, there's so much room for error, ng human error. And there's only a few. Okay, sobrang konti lang po in the whole Bible na merong mga ganitong quote-unquote errors. So, ganito yung picture, ano? Halimbawa, ako yung scribe. Sinusulat ko yung Romans 8 verse 1. Okay? Tapos, nabasa ko, therefore, there is now no condemnation in Christ Jesus, period. Eh, hindi nag-a-agree si scribe. Sabi niya, ha? Hindi ko pwedeng isulat to ng ganito. Pag sinulat ko to ng ganito, people would think na they can just sin. Na wala naman palang condemnation, hindi na pala ako kukondemn at all. So baka itapon nila yung buhay nila, baka i-accept nila si Jesus, tapos bigla na lang nilang pabayaan na lang nila, they just live a carnal life. Baka hindi ganito yung ibig sabihin nito. And nakita niya yung verse 4. Yung verse 4, pag tinignan nyo, sige, go ahead, look at that. Ang nakalagay doon, who walk not according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. So si scribe, ay nag-assume, baka naman ang ibig sabihin ni Paul is hindi ka i-condemn as long as you live according to the Spirit. So, ginawa niya, pinanik niya yung verse 4. Kaya may mga Bible na hindi period, but it's sounded like conditional, na hindi ka i-condemn ni Jesus Christ as long as you walk not according to the flesh, but in the Spirit. Now, nararamdaman ko na yung mga ibang tao sa bahay. Parang, ba't mo naman alam yun? Imbento ka talaga. Ikaw si Pastor Roy, imbento. Paano mo naman alam yun na gano'n nangyari? Well, kasi this is not in the original manuscripts. Nung nakakita po sa Qumran Caves nung 1942 to 1957, if I'm not mistaken, merong mga mas luma. Again, ang mas basis natin, yung mga mas lumang manuscript. May mga nakita pong manuscript doon sa Qumran Caves or what popularly known as the Dead Sea Scrolls. Wala po ito. So we can, and we honor that. And so we are confident to say, now, what Paul meant when he wrote this, can we show the verse again? No condemnation in Christ Jesus, period. Now, why am I making so much of a fuss? Because importante to, pre. Pakinggan mo, ano? Kung yan ay comma at hindi period, ganito, every single day, you look at yourself. Every single day, you check yourself. Did I walk according to the Spirit today? Naku, hindi na naman. Naku, makukondem ako. Sabi kasi doon, no condemnation if I walk in the Spirit. And tanong, sino ba talaga sa ating lahat ang nakaka-walk in the Spirit and not in the flesh every day, probably all of us will fail. And then you will try again. Sige bukas, I will try to walk in the Spirit. And then you will try it again, and then you will fail, and then you will try again, then you will fail, and then you're back to chapter 7 that you're doing I want to walk in the Spirit, but I can't. Pero mga kapatid, because of the period, no condemnation in Christ Jesus, period. You're not looking inward. You're looking at the cross. You're looking at the cross. That because of what Jesus did, because of what Christ has done in the cross, there is no condemnation, period. Therefore, it gives you the freedom to walk in the Spirit. I'll talk about that in a while. In a cancel culture, alam nyo, we live in a cancel culture. Nakakalungkot, di ba? Parang lahat na lang, wala ka nang pwedeng sabihin na hindi ika-cancel. Yung nag-show ka lang naman ng picture ng bike, alam nyo tong story ng to, no? Nag-show ka ng picture ng bike, tapos may magka-cancel. Uy, di kayo na mayaman, napaka-insensitive nyo naman, ECQ ngayon, yung papapakita yung mayaman. Nag-picture lang eh. Gumawa ng rap yung isa. Naku, kaya lang naman yung sikat kasi dahil mayaman yung mga magulang niyan. Yan. Pag meron kang gustong sabihin na belief mo, you know what? I think, I believe that there are only two sexes, the male and the female. Ay, hindi mo na kami nirespeto. Grabe ka. Wala ka nang pwedeng sabihin sa mundong to na hindi ika-cancel. In a world where, actually another term for cancel culture is a condemnation culture. Na lahat na lang kinocondemn natin, lahat na lang. Well, hindi ka na pwedeng magsalita. Yung freedom of speech, I don't think that's true anymore because if you say what you think, someone will cancel it. Someone will condemn it. In a cancel culture, we are certain that our justification will never be canceled. In a cancel culture, we are certain that our justification will never be canceled. It's never gonna be canceled. Hindi mo kailangan to tiptoe every day to see, am I walking in the Spirit? Am I doing this because makokondem ako? Guys, you look at the cross. You look at the finished work of Jesus Christ and it's done. Okay? Double jeopardy ang tawag dito. Okay? Meron ng kumuha ng punishment. It's done. It's gone. It's finished. Tetelestai. Tapos na yan. Number two, our power is here. Ang title nitong preaching nito, I have the power with the He-Man voice. Okay? Remember that cartoon, old cartoons? I have the power! And there's gonna be power. Okay? Look, for the law of the Spirit, kung di kayo na-convince mamaya, kanina, nung explanation ko, ngayon, mako-convince ko kayo kung ano ibig sabihin ng walking in the Spirit. Tingin nyo, verse 2, for the law of the Spirit of life has set you free in Christ Jesus from the law of sin and death. For God has done what the law, weakened by the flesh, could not do. By sending His own Son in the likeness of sinful flesh and for sin, He condemns sin in the flesh in order that, listen to this, that the righteous requirement of the law might be fulfilled in us. Sabihin nyo nga, in us. So that the righteous requirement of the law might be fulfilled in us. Hindi sinabing by us. Hindi sinabing fulfillin mo yung law. Tingnan nyo, yun yung kinabit ng mga scribe, nung scribe, who walk not according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. So, the power to do the things, to obey the law, to give smile to God is not on your own power but by the Spirit. Kanina no, binilang ko yung personal pronouns 19. Ngayon binilang ko yung Spirit 14 times. Nakita niyo ba yung very simple na nilagay ni Paul doon na parang gold mine? Eh kaya ka nag-fail. Because you're doing it by your own power, by your own strength, by your own wisdom, by your own willpower, by your own strategy. Kaya ka namamatay. Kaya ka may body of death. Kaya mo pinipilit magsayaw. Eh, wala ka nga. Mermaid ka nga. You can't. Now, Paul is giving you a new alternative because there's a new law and the Holy Spirit just explodes in this chapter 14 times. Spirit, 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 Spirit. Spirit. John chapter 16, ano, in the last supper, sabi ni Jesus, he was talking to his friends and said, guys, I have to go. I have to leave. I'm going to my Father. And sabi niya, but, it's okay. It's gonna be for your advantage that I leave because if I will not leave, then the Helper will not go with you. Imagine mo, ikaw yung kasama ng disciples at sabi ni Jesus sa'yo, guys, aalis na ako. I mean, but there's someone parakletos, a helper that will go after me. And this guy who raised the dead, who feed 5,000 people, who stopped the storm, who healed the sick, raised people from the dead, and said, wala pa yun. In fact, mabuti nga umalis ako. Kasi pag alis ko, mayroong parating. Parating na tutulungan kanya sa lahat. Eh kung ako yung mga disciples, I probably say, galing yung mag-pep talk nitong ni Jesus. Pero hindi siguro. Iyan ka na eh. I mean, the second person of the Trinity, you're here and you're saying there's someone that's gonna be on at least on par with you. But Jesus was serious. Sabi niya, he will guide you. He will teach you about all things. He will not glorify himself. He will point me to the Father, and he will teach you about the future, and he will help you all things. And remember, these disciples as well cannot do. In fact, pansinin niya, no? Naalala ko lang bigla. Nagawa nila yung mga miracles. Not when they were with Jesus, but when Jesus left. Totoo nga that better things are yet to come. Better things happened when Jesus left because they touched the power. Okay? So, pag binalikan natin yung verse, may dalawang contrast. Ang tawag dito contrast. The law of sin and death versus the law of the Spirit. The law of sin and death versus the law of the Spirit. The law, by the way, verse 2, verse 3, pagka binanggit yung law, it's not talking of a law na nakasulat, it's talking about a principle. Okay? The principle of the sin and death. Parang ganun. The principle of what I mean is, when you say the law of gravity, wala naman talagang nakasulat na law. Okay? Pero the principle of gravity. When you say the law of sin and death, it's talking about the law that when you sin, it leads to death. Okay? The innate desire to do the wrong thing. Yun nga yun, chapter 7, ha? Gusto ko namang sumunod sa Diyos eh, pero bakit ganun yung mga bawal? Yun yung gusto kong gawin. Diba? Sinabi na nga na bawal to, yun pa rin yung gagawin. Hanggang makakalusot. Okay? Not having the legs, the aerial syndrome, the aerial sickness na gusto kong sumayaw kaso wala akong paa. The body of death, that everything that I go is feels that I'm not alive. Yun po yung the law of sin and death. Sabi ni Paul, mamili ka anong gusto mo, the law of sin and death or the law of the Spirit. Sa verse 3, sabi doon, God has done what the law weakened by the flesh could not do. Now in verse 3, the term law there is talking about the Mosaic law. Okay? Ibig sabihin, okay naman tong law, Mosaic law. Okay naman to. It's just that we can't. It, because of our flesh, we can't. Okay? We cannot obey the law. Maganda yung law. Nothing wrong with the law. We cannot do it. Balik tayo kay Ariel. You have tails. You cannot dance. You want to do it, but you can't. And it was weakened by the law. Now, Because of that, God introduced a new law, and that's the law of the Spirit. Yung iba, I'm probably losing you somewhere, so I'm gonna give a couple of examples. If sa mga Sherlock Holmes fans, yes, this is from Sherlock, okay? If I say, I want to fly, kahit I desire to fly, kahit ba passionate ako na mag-fly, and I jump out of the building, jump off the building, what do you think will happen? Ano mangyayari? Kahit sabihin ko, I believe I can fly, kumanta ka pa, I believe I can fly, na, kahit gaano ka pa ka-passionate, di ba? Hindi, naniniwala ako na makakalipad ako. Woo! Subukan mong tumalon. What will happen to you? You're gonna splat in the ground, right? Why? Because the law of gravity demands that you fall. Kahit ba naniniwala ka pa? Kahit ba hindi, ipupusta ko yung buhay ko. Hindi ako mamamatay. The law of gravity demands that you fall. In the same way, yun nga lang, tao lang. And in the same way, how many of you believe this 183,000 kilo of metal scrap will fly? Okay? Eh, yung isang kilo nga, itapon mo sa air or probably out of the building. Of course, it will fall. It will fall. Why? Because the law of gravity demands that whatever goes up, what goes down. Pero, ito na. Ting! Ito na yung clincher. Alam nyo ba, yung 183,000 kilos, ganun din kabigat ang isang Boeing 747 plane. But, the plane flies. So, what's happening here? Because there's a greater law that supersedes the law of gravity, and that's the law of aerodynamics. Totoo pa rin yung law ng gravity, pero merong superseding law. And that's the law of aerodynamics. Quickly lang, ano, paano ba lumilipad yung isang aeroplano? It's being pulled into four forces, yung downward force, yung lift, yung thrust, and yung drag, the friction that air drag, na kapag tumatama yung air sa wings. Now, ang concept ng aeroplano ay kailangang mas malakas yung forward force at yung upward force than the downward force. And the shape of the wings is designed to do that exactly. Mga stock knowledge lang today, walang review to. Mga naalala ko nung grade 4. You see, and because of that, 183,000 kilo of metal will fly because the law of aerodynamics supersedes the law of gravity. So, balik natin sa kanina, no? The law of aerodynamics is greater than the law of gravity. And what Paul is saying here is the law of the Spirit is greater than the law of sin and death. So, ganun na lang yan, pre. Okay? Totoo pa rin. Totoo pa rin na may innate desire ka to do the wrong thing. Totoo pa rin na selfish ka. Totoo pa rin na ayaw mong mag-victory group. Okay? Totoo pa rin na ayaw mong mag-tights. Totoo pa rin na ayaw mong mag-forgive. Totoo pa rin na gusto mong iwanan yung asawa mo to commit adultery. Totoo pa din that you want to do only what's good for you. Pero, kapatid, meron ng pwedeng available na power sa'yo, and that is the power of the Holy Spirit that supersedes the law of sin and death. Now, because of that, you have the power to say no to sin. And you don't have to do it by your own. And if you allow the Spirit to dwell in you, if you allow the Spirit to live in you, then you have the power to do the impossible things that a man, dati hindi ka nakakalipad, ngayon you can fly. Because of the power of the Spirit. I love this poem. I don't know who's the author of this. Sabi niya, do this and live, the law commands, but gives me neither feet nor hands. A better word the gospel brings, it bids me fly and gives me wings. Wow. Binigyan tayo ng law na hindi naman natin kayang matupad. In fact, that's the point last week, that the law is just there. And it's not good. Paul is saying the law is good. It's just that we cannot do it. And we will be frustrated. We will be depressed. There's a lot of people just quitting Christianity because of that. Pero, kapatid, the Holy Spirit is here. He's your helper. Every time there's a temptation, every time you're falling down, every time you think you cannot preach the gospel, every time that you think that you are not good enough, the Holy Spirit is there. There's a new law that supersedes. Dati, a man cannot fly because the law of gravity. Now, you can fly because the law of aerodynamics, the law of the Spirit, that is the better law. Now, because of that, beginning to land this, our practice will be different. Number three, our practice will be different. Dahil may power ka na nasa iyo and you claim it every single day, the way you live your life will be different. Okay? It's gonna change the way you live. It's gonna change the way you think. Verse 5, for those who live according to the flesh set their minds on the things of the flesh, but those who live according to the Spirit set their minds on the things of the Spirit. For to set the mind on the flesh is death, but to set the mind on the Spirit is life and peace. Another contrast here is mindset on the things of the flesh and mindset on the things of the Spirit. Ngayon, kapatid, ulit, no? Kung wala si Christ sa'yo, automatic yon. Kung wala si Christ sa'yo, automatic yon. That you have no power, okay, to do anything good. Your mind is set on the things of the flesh. Okay, you're just worrying about this life, this temporary life. You're just worrying what to eat. You're just worrying what you're gonna wear. You're just worrying about your children's education. Iniisip mo lang kung magkano ba pera mo sa banko. Iniisip mo lang, paano ko mag... Yun lang. Okay? And you just think of how you will be happy on how to satisfy the desires of the flesh, the Bible says. And kaya ang isip mo lang laging sa mundong to. Eat, drink, and marry, for tomorrow you will die. Okay? Kaya okay lang sa'yo mag-sex and mag-drugs and mag-iinom and all. Kasi ito lang naman yung buhay. Ang tawag po doon, hedonism. May mga hedonists that lives for pleasure. Meron ka pang bucket list. By the way, let me just comment on that a little bit. Na-offend talaga ako. Yung parang, I'm not saying mag-travel. We love traveling. We want to go all of these places. Pero yung parang hindi kailangan kong makita yun eh. Kasi sana man lang makita ko bago ko mamatay. Sana makita ko man lang yung Mount Everest bago ko mamatay. Sana man lang makapunta ko sa Palawan bago ko mamatay. Kasi ang gandang-ganda nun. Do you think the mountains in heaven are not much more beautiful? Do you think the lakes and the ocean? Guys, heaven is much, much more beautiful than this life. So don't set your mind on things of the flesh. My car, my house, my future, what I'm gonna eat, what I'm gonna wear. Kaya uubos ka ng time and energy to sustain this life. Or to prolong this life. Nandi, kailangan mabuhay, kailangan mabuhay. Pag merong terminal na sakit, uubusin mo lahat ng pera mo, kailangan siyang mabuhay kasi nakatingin ka lang sa the things of the flesh. Now, if you have the power in you, mga kapatid, hindi mo ito pipilitin. If you have Jesus Christ in you, the Holy Spirit will dwell in you, and then you have the power, Romans chapter 12, verse 2, that says that your mind's gonna be renewed, be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Now, suddenly, things are changing. Your outlook changes, your perspective changes, because now, you're looking at eternity. Now, your mind is set on the things of the Spirit. Yung alam mo, mauubos yung ipon mo, pero hindi, susuportahan ko itong campus missionary na to. Kasi, yung ginagawa niya, pang eternity. Kikita nyo, nag-shift. Dati hindi. Pag ginastos ko to, mauubusan ako ng pera, wala na kami for next year, so wag na lang. Kaya ka mag-Victory Group kahit online lang. Eh kaysa naman nag-ML ka lang, nagpaparang ka lang, nanonood ka lang ng Netflix, para sa akin to eh. When I go to a Victory Group, kahit ba online lang yan, I am studying the Word of God and I am building relationship with people that I will be for eternity. Pre, gugustuhin mo ba yung Kristiyano ko nga pagdating mo sa langit, wala kang kakilala? Di ba wala kang kakilala kasi wala kang ginawang kaibigan eh. But jo-join ka sa Victory Group kasi alam mo yung mga relationships na to eternal. Set your mind and things of the Spirit. Sabi pa dito, if your mind is set on the flesh, then it will just bring death. Pero if you set your mind on the Spirit, it will bring life and peace. Kapatid, kung wala kang peace ngayon, you ask the Holy Spirit to dwell in you. Kung every single day, worry, fear, doubt, sinabi na nga ni Jesus eh, do not worry about what you will eat or what you will drink or what you will wear. You look at the birds in the sky, don't you think that the Heavenly Father feeds them? You are much more important than that. Kung kapatid, nakakalungkot na buhay yun eh. Body of death, you still have it. Like every day you go up and you say you're a Christian and walang peace. Walang peace. We're just like everyone else. We're concerned. Kailan ba mawala yung COVID? Kailan yung ekonomiya bumabaksak? Puro fear. I invite you to ask the Holy Spirit to dwell in you today. So there's gonna be a renewing of your mind. There's gonna be a shift. Ibig ba sabihin nun, we will not, hindi na tayo magkakotse, hindi na tayo magdadamit. No! We use these things. In fact, ngayon nga pong ECQ, lima yata yung pinag-pray ko na may kotse. May bagong kotse. Natuwa nga ako. Kasi sabi ko, grabe si Lord sa inyo. Ha? Wala nang pera buong mundo. Tapos kayo may kotse pa. Sabi ko sa kanila, alam nyo pa paano magiging eternal yung kotse? Temporary lang yan eh. Things of the flesh lang yan eh. Gusto mo bang i-convert natin to things of the Spirit? Gamitin mo yung kotse mo to build memories. Because memories are eternal. Lumabas kayo ng pamilya nyo, mag-road trip kayo because memories are eternal. Mag-Victory Group kayo, sama nyo yung mga Victory Group nyo, mag-road trip kayo because relationships are eternal. Mag-disciple ka, okay, mag-inspire ka. Alam nyo, nung wala pa po akong kotse, alam ni Pastor Eric to, and Pastor Eric, if you're watching, thank you po. Wala pa akong kotse, sinasama niya lang ako sa kotse niya, tapos ini-inspire niya ako, Rui, balang araw, magkakaganito ka. Kasi ako, ganyan parang, totoo ba? He inspired me. Okay, gamitin mo yung kotse mo, things of the flesh, so that magiging things of the Spirit. Kasi yun, eternal. Sabi ko, mag-serve ka, lalo ngayon, COVID, pag bumalik yung services, yung mga hindi maka-attend ng service kasi takot dahil magko-commute sila, isakay mo kaya sa kotse. Do you understand? Set your things on the things of the Spirit. Verse 11, again, I don't have the time. There's so many rich verses yet, but I need to jump in here, in this verse. If the Spirit of Him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, He who raised Christ Jesus from the dead will also give life to your mortal bodies through His Spirit who dwells in you. I'm gonna say that again very, very slowly kasi kinikilabutan ako kasi ang sarap. Look at that. This Christ Jesus, who was raised from the dead, will also give life to your mortal bodies through His Spirit who dwells in you. I started off this preaching looking at Ariel na she wants to do a lot of things, but she can't. And I showed you the body of death that's causing you to die every single day. Nambuhay ka nga, pero hindi totoo, hindi talaga. You're dying every day. You know what? You can unlock that. Because the power is here. Simula nung Pentecost, Acts chapter 2, the power is here. It's with you if you're available. Last story I'm gonna tell. I remember this movie, The Croods. Naalala niyo? They're just so afraid to go out. This family, The Croods. Okay? Kaya every single day, they don't want to explore. Every single day, mag-hunt lang silang mabilis mga pagkain, and they're gonna lock themselves in their caves once more. You remember that? Okay? Mabilis na mag-hunt, and then go back. Go back to the cave. Yung pala, there's a lot more out there na hindi nila matouch, hindi nila ma-explore, hindi nila magawa. Kasi takot sila eh. In fact, yun nga yung motto ng tatay niya. Sabi niya, never not be afraid. And I think like, there's a lot of people like that living in fear and doubt and worry, and it's a sad life, kaibigan. It's a sad life na walang faith, na hindi ka naniniwala sa miracles, na puro logic, na puro kung ano lang yung practical. It's sad. Depressing that you cannot do the things that you want to do. In fact, sabi ni Eve, I will never forget that. Sabi ng tatay niya, but I'm keeping us alive. That's why I'm doing that. Sabi niya, I wasn't living. That was just not dying. And I don't want that life for you, friend. I don't want that life for you. Na ito yung power ng Holy Spirit available for you. Ayaw mo. Kasi gusto mo yung safe. Gusto mo yung di kailangan ng faith. Gusto mong gawin mo sa sarili mong lakas. 19 pronouns. I, me, I. But at the end of the day, He can't. Right now, there's a better law. The law of the Spirit. That He can dwell in you today. Alright? This is weird, no? This is weird. Because I feel like the Holy Spirit's gonna have a baptism right now over the internet. Alright? Guys, alam ko magkakapamilya kayo, no? So medyo nagkakahiyaan kayo ngayon. But if you want that body of death gone, matanggal mo to. That's causing you to die every single day. I really encourage you to be in faith. Stand up. Kung nakaupo ka lang sa cellphone ka, stand up. Raise your hands. Because we will receive the power of the Holy Spirit again. And it will change our mind. Acts chapter 2, remember that. They were afraid, they were scared, they were in doubt. But the Holy Spirit came upon them and boom! Pagbaba nila, they're radical, passionate, crazy for Jesus Christ. And I believe we can do the same thing today. Go ahead, raise your hands. If you're a father, meron kayong mga anak, o ikaw mismo, lihas mo yung sarili mo kasi ikaw mismo yung negative eh. Just raise your hands. Lord, I pray for the Holy Spirit to change the way we live today, to change our life, to change our mind, transform our mind today. We cannot do that on our own. Lord, we don't have legs. We have mermaid's tail. We can't. We cannot do anything. We cannot obey the law. We cannot stop this sin. We cannot be generous. We don't want to be discipled. We don't want to be generous. We don't want to be forgive. But we are stopping to rely on ourselves today. Ask the indwelling of the Holy Spirit today to transform us. Go ahead, raise your hands. Holy Spirit, just guide us, God. Holy Spirit, Lord, we want you. We want you. We want you. We want you in our life, Lord. We don't want this life, this fearful, doubtful, worryful life. We don't want that, Lord. Transform us today. Thank you, Lord. Receive the power of the Holy Spirit. You can feel it. Kahit nasa mga bahay niyo, nararamdaman niyo yan. You can feel it. It's warm. Probably some of you will start to shake. Probably some of you are crying right now. If feeling mo lumuhod ka, then do it. If feeling mo gusto mong umiyak and just say sorry to God, then just do it. Because the Holy Spirit is transforming us today. Lord, thank you, God. Change the way we live. Change the way we walk. Change the way we think. But we will not walk in the flesh. We will not live in the flesh. We will walk in the Spirit. And everything that the Spirit does. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Let's just worship God. Let's just worship God today.